A balloon is at rest on the ground, is rising upward with an acceleration g by h. The stone is dropped from the balloon when it is at a height capital H. Show that the time taken by the stone to touch the ground is 2 root h by g. 2 root h by g. So let's see the problem. What is the main focus is? So here is my ground level. Clear? So if this is my ground level, suppose this is height h. So this is balloon. From where we have dropped the stone towards the ground. So first of all, it is moving with an acceleration g by a. As we can see, it is moving with an acceleration g by a. So let's see what is the velocity attained by the balloon when it reached at a height capital H. Okay, so what formula we will use? We can use v equal to u plus a t. V equal to u plus at. Normal formula, what is easy to use, V equal to u plus at, no problem. Now the thing is that V equal to u plus at, if I use here a is what, this will acceleration, so V equal to u plus at we use. Initial velocity is 0, so 0, no problem. Achha. Plus here acceleration g by a into t. Okay, now t is the unknown factor. So let's see if I use another formula. We can use also v square equal to u square plus 2as. This formula. In place of s, I can put what? H. In place of h, s, I can put h. Clear? So in place of s, I can put h. If I am putting h, so let's see what is happening. Wait. Okay. So this is the thing. If I am putting h, so u is again 0, so plus 2 g by a h, so 2 to the 4, 2 4 is the 8, so g by 4 h, which means v equal to root g h by 4, or I can write that root g h by 2. V square, so this can be written as root 2 g h, g h by 4. Okay, no problem. Now the thing is that when the stone released from the balloon, now if the stone released from the balloon, so from there, as you can see the diagram, so if the stone released from the balloon, so what? Whenever you are releasing stone from the balloon, so balloon continuously moving with the velocity. So here at this point of time, we are having velocity v. After that, balloon has the initial velocity the stone has the initial velocity as v, and after that, when it touches the ground, it has the final velocity 0. So when we are coming for the balloon concept, so what is happening? In that time, I am using that h formula, that h will be equal to what? H will be equal to, means s equal to ut plus half gt square, s equal to ut plus half gt square. Now, if this is I am taking as my reference level for the stone, so this is what? Negative, reference frame, this is my positive direction, this is my negative direction. So for balloon, what is my equation? Same equation, that is h equal to ut. Right now this u is my v, ut I am writing, so minus ut plus half g t square minus ut plus half gt square. Clear? Minus ut plus half gt square. Now minus ut, as I am saying, what is my the initial velocity of u balloon stone is same as the velocity of the balloon at that point of time. Same as the velocity of the balloon at that point of time. Clear? So if I am doing so, what I am getting? getting that putting this velocity over here in place of u put, therefore minus root gh by 2t plus half g t square. Why? Because whenever it releases from the balloon, then it has the same velocity. Done. Now this terminal also I am having h. I want t. So if I want t, so what I am regarding calculation I am doing over here. So if I am doing calculation over here, so what I can write? I can write here, let's see, h plus gh by 2 t minus half g t square equal to 0. Clear? So 2h plus root gh t minus g t square. So see, it is a clear things we are having a what I can say, that quadratic equation. So if I alternate the sign, we are having that is g t square minus root g h t minus 2h equal to 0. These are the thing. So g t square minus root g h minus 2h, okay, g t square minus 2 root g h minus 2h. Clear? Things are clear. So let's solve it for the t. Means if I use Sridharacharya formula, so what I am having, if I am using Sridharacharya formula, so t equal to minus b, minus minus plus, so plus gh plus minus minus b plus minus root over b square g square h square plus 4ac, 4gh, 4ac. A is what? A is here g, c is 2h. So 2 goes like another 4. So 2, that is 2, 4. 2 to the 4. So 4, 4 to the 8. So 8gh by 2a. 2 into what? 2 into g. These are the thing. So let's see what is happening. So from here what is coming, that is g square h square, b square minus 4, sorry, this will be gh because it's the only root. So gh, so 8gh plus that gh will be coming that 9gh. 9gh means 3gh. So plus root gh plus minus 3 root gh by 2g. Which means if I do plus, I will have 4 root gh by 2g. Clear? And if I do minus, minus is not possible. If I do minus, then time will coming at negative, which is not possible. So here what I am having, that is root gh. So 2 to the 4. So from there I will have t equal to 2 root h by g. Proof. 2 root h by g, which is my required thing.